Greetings everyone, Fountain Unicorn here. Welcome to my channel. This is a systematic step-by-step course that will help you master the essential skills of quantitative trading using the powerful programming language Python. In this video, we are going to build a simple trading strategy. How exciting! Well, let's get started. Just a kind reminder, this course is meant for educational purpose only. The data and information presented in this video is not investment advice, okay? So if you haven't been following along with this video so far, then I have a link in the description section below that links to where you can download all the data demo codes so you can follow along with this, okay? And please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and click the bell icon on to receive the latest updates. Thank you. As we discussed in the last video, MA, the moving average, is a statistical analysis indicator that refers to an average price for a particular trading instrument over a specified period. It is used by investors and traders to track and identify trends by smoothing normal day-to-day price fluctuations. The time frame or length you choose for a moving average is called the look-back period. And MA with a short time frame reacts much quicker to price changes than an MA with a long look-back period. For example, the 40-day moving average tracks the actual price more closely than the 200-day moving average. We can call the 40-day MA the fast signal and the 200-day MA the slow signal. As the market trend moves up, there's a key line you want to watch. That is the 50-day moving average. A 50-day MA indicator takes 10 weeks of stock market price data and then plots the average. The moving line is recalculated every day. This will show the stock price trend. It can either be up, down, or sideways. The MA50 acts as support or resistance level for the stock price. In an upward trend, the MA50 will act as a support. Stock price should always bounce back up after touching the MA50. If you have a long position when the stock market closes below the indicator, then this will be an exit signal. In a downtrend, the MA50 will act as a resistance. Stock price should always go down after touching the moving average. If you have a short position when the stock market closes above the indicator, then that is an exit signal. In short, if the market price stays above 50-day MA, that is a good signal. If the market drops below the 50-day MA in heavy volume, watch out. There could be a trend reversal signal ahead. You normally should only buy when stock prices are above their 50-day MA. This tells you the current stock price direction is trending up, is trending upward. You always want to trade with a trend and not against it. Many traders only open orders in the direction of the market trend. Now let's take a look at the 10-day moving average. 10-day moving average is a popular near-term technical indicator. Graphically, you find it as a trend line on the price chart that represents the averages of the closing prices of the last 10 trading days. So MAs are constantly used in combination to spot bullish and bearish crossover signals. Let's take the combination of MA10 and MA50 as an example. They are fast signal and slow signal, respectively. So a crossover signal is created when two different MAs cross over in a chart. A bullish crossover, also known as a golden cross, happens when the short-term MA crosses above a long-term one, suggesting the start of an upward trend. In contrast, a bearish crossover or death cross happens when a short-term MA crosses below a long-term moving average, which indicates the beginning of a downtrend. The moving average theory is one of the most common technical indicators for the applications at present. It is a useful tool to help traders identify existing trends, judge trends to emerge, and find trends that are overextended and going to invert. With that being said, now let's create our own trading model. Our strategy is if MA crosses above MA 50 or if MA 10 crosses above MA 50, we will buy one share of the stock and hold it, as it is a signal suggesting the start of an upward trend. When MA 10 crosses below MA 50, we will sell the share, as it is a signal suggesting the beginning of a downtrend. Here, from the charts, we can see that those arrows indicate the days of which we buy and hold one share of a stock. Well, that looks good. Now let's create a new variable. I call it shares. This variable is to denote whether we buy or sell. See the code here? That's the least comprehension we learned in our last video. Good to see you, old friend. Well, basically the codes say if MA 10 is greater than MA 50, the value of shares is 1. Otherwise, it is 0. Okay, simple and easy. Let's move on to compute daily profit. First, we need to create a new variable called close one, because the value in close one is the close price of any trading day's next day. That's why we use shift negative one to move the data one row upward. Then we add a new column, profit, to show us the daily profit. If the value of shares equals one, the daily profit is calculated as the close price of next day minus the close price of today. If the result is a negative number, it means we lose money on that day. If the value of shares is equal to zero, it means we do not possess any share on that day. That's no profit or loss for us to take. Okay, so let's plot the profit to take a look at the statistical graph of the profit. Well, it shows sometimes we win, sometimes we lose. But this is not good enough. We want to know the aggregate profit or loss over the initial amount of money over a period of years. Let's find out. Here I'm using the pandas data frame COMSUM method. The COMSUM method returns a data frame with the cumulative sum for each row. The COMSUM method goes through the values in the data frame from the top row by row, adding the values with the value from the previous row, ending up with the data frame where the last row contains the sum of all values for each column. So if the axis parameter is set to axis equals columns, the method goes through the values column by column and ends up with the data frame where the last columns contains the sum of all values for each row. I'm going to create a new column called wealth. The value of wealth in each row represents the aggregate amount of profit or loss we take at the date shown in the index by using this trading strategy. Overall, during the investment horizon, this strategy makes about $145. In the last row, the profit and the wealth have NAN values because we don't have any data beyond February 2nd. And those returns are computed from close one. And close one is calculated using shift negative one. You can use the Jobna method to remove any not a number data if you don't want to see them. To realize this profit, we need to buy one share of stock on the first day. So our initial investment is the stock's close price on the first day. This strategy seems to be very promising, but not good enough to implement it in real market yet. Can we find a better signal for trading? Of course, yes. We will delve into more details in our future tutorials. That's all for today. Congratulations on finishing this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and share it out. If you have any inquiries or concerns, feel free to reach out and leave a comment. In our next video, we will learn random variables which play an important role helping us making better market predictions and investment decisions. How exciting! Well, thank you for your time, and I look forward to connecting with you soon. Goodbye.